Welcome to this video. In this video, we will show you how to calibrate a KST30, a 3590 GT scale, in this case a bench scale. So it's complete. As you can see here, we have platform and the indicator over there. We can turn on by clicking on the on-off button right here. The touchscreen will light up, showing the NERGEO and the, in this case, the error for the calibration. Then we can click here. He asks us to restore if we, because sometime could be some problem, so we can restore the settings. And now we are inside the technical setup. As you can see here, the calibration is on the top, so we can click here and the calibration menu will show up. We can choose how many scale we want. We have only one in this case. And if we go on scale one, the indicator will show us four different parameters. Here we can choose for the decimal, the unit of measure, number of range, if we want a multi-range or a multi-division, the actually division for this range, and the capacity. If we have more than one range, obviously we can choose. In this case, this platform have two range. Why? Because you can have more precision in one scale. So we can see here already the division setted, but if we want to set a new division, we can go here and I can choose between the division, as you can see. The full capacity of this scale is 30 kg and the first range is 12 kg. And you can see the first range is 12 kg and the division is 2 gram. On the second range we have 5 gram with 30 kg. We can go back here. And again on scale one and go with the calibration. The calibration in this case is a wizard procedure, so the indicator will tell you everything you need to do. In fact, here he's asking us to insert the points over the zero. Usually one is enough. You can go from 1 to 8. If you input more, the calibration will be much more precise, but 1 point is more than enough. Now, be sure to have the scale clear, so the indicator could take the zero calibration. We can confirm, and the indicator now is asking for the first point of calibration. And in this case, to have a perfect calibration, we should put the maximum capacity, so 30 kg. We confirm. Now the indicator is asking us to put the weight over the scale, so I will go to take it. Another 10 kg. And now we have loaded our weights. The calibration is successful. You can see from here, obviously, the indicator will tell you, and from the tone. If the calibration wasn't successful, there will be a message here, an error, and the tone will be different. So now we can remove the weight from the scale. And we can simply press ESC, and the indicator is asking about the parameter change, if we want to save or not. In this case, we want to save the parameter change. And then, after the booting of the indicator, we can see our zero, perfect zero on the scale. This is the actual standard display of this type of firmware. And if I put my 5K, I will see my perfect 5 and the division are going up by 2 grams. If I go over the 12 kilogram, the division will rise up by 5. Thank you for watching, and if you need anything else and you have any question about the scale, you can contact us by phone or going to the website.